Hi, my name is Colin Zauner. I'm an Applications Controls Engineer here at KEB America. This video series will overview how to collect data from a Compactlogix PLC and push it to an AWS IoT endpoint using our C6 router and COMBIVIS Connect. The software programs that we're going to be using is KEB's COMBIVIS Connect, KEB's COMBIVIS Studio HMI software, and also the AWS console. All the AWS services that we're going to be using are in the free tier program, so before you start following along with this video, make sure you set up an account for yourself. To get started, we're going to log into the AWS console and start to configure the AWS services. First, log into the AWS console and choose the AWS IoT service. Choose Onboard from the resource options on the left side of the console. We'll be configuring the C6 router using the AWS Connection Wizard. Under Configuring a Device, select Get Started, and finally select Get Started again. On the next screen, choose a development platform. This won't matter. I'll choose Windows and then select Node.js SDK Kit and select Next. AWS calls all devices in the cloud things. Things are simply records of your physical devices connected to the cloud. In this case, I'll just use the name C6 Router Demo. When you are finished naming the thing, download the connection kit to your machine. This will include the security certificates required to publish messages to the AWS cloud. If you want, you can run a script to test your connection. For now, I'll skip this and move on. To see the newly created thing, select Manage and Things. Before we move on, take note of the HTTP endpoint that the router will be publishing data to. Before we move on, we need to define a set of policies and rules that AWS services can use when they run. Let's go to the IAM Management Console and create a role that will give the AWS IoT, AWS DynamoDB, and CloudWatch full access to our project. In a production environment, you may want to limit the policies further to increase security and protect from mistakes. Once our security policy is set up, we'll need to set up a rule to process the data that gets published from the router. The router sends data packets in a binary format for faster and efficient data transfer of the tags it logs. Each packet will need to be decoded into JSON format using a rule and a Lambda function. To create a rule that will process every packet received from the router, select Act and Create. Give the rule a name, and then I'll write an SQL query that will match the data packets coming in. Use SQL version 2016.3.23. Then give a name for the topic that the router will subscribe to. I'll use Raw. Now we will create an action to match each data query. The action will trigger a Lambda function that will process the data to JSON and send it to a database. The Lambda service is a compute service offered by AWS that can run code in response to events without a server. AWS handles all the compute resources behind the scenes. To configure the Lambda function, select Add Action and select the option to invoke a Lambda function passing the message data. Then select Create a New Resource and give the new function a name using the Node.js 6.10 runtime, and select the permission role we previously created. Finally, select Create Function. Next, we need to enter the code that will run to process the raw data from the router and send it to a DynamoDB database. I have the code already prepared for me. I will attach this in the link below. Copy and paste the code into the function code box. The sample code will need to be modified slightly with our thing endpoint and the name of the DynamoDB table that we will push data to. Copy the thing URL and paste it in the script. After modifying our script, scroll down and configure a timeout to stop the code in case of an error. 5 seconds is more than enough time for our example. Finally, save the function in the IoT rule window. Click Add Action and Create Rule, selecting the newly created Lambda function. The last step for setting up our AWS services will be to create a DynamoDB table. Find the AWS resource DynamoDB from the Resources console and select it. Select Create Table and write the name all messages that we used in the Lambda script previously. I'll keep all the settings at default for now and press Create the Table. At this point, we are finished with the AWS services setup, and we are now ready to configure the C6 router and its data logging project to publish data to the AWS cloud. The next step is to configure the COMBIVIS Studio HMI project that we're going to load onto the KEB's router. This project will consist of a data logger that will collect data from our Compactlogix PLC. Finally, all the data that's collected will be pushed up to the AWS cloud. Let's get started. Once you have COMBIVIS Studio HMI project, we will first start and create a new blank project. Common projects used by the C6 router include dashboards, email and SMS notifications, and also alarms. For this video, I'll just focus on the data logging functionality. We will create a project using the project wizard. So first, select File, New, and a startup wizard will open. The router has a Windows CE 7 operating system, so I'll select this option. Give the project a name and select a path to save the project. The HMI runtime will always be advanced for any of our router products. The user options can be left as default, and the COM driver we will use is Ethernet IP for the Compactlogix. Select Next. For simplicity, I'll create a blank screen with a width of 800 by 600 to match the router desktop resolution. Everything else I'll uncheck as we will be configuring the data loggers manually and won't be using any alarms. When you are finished with all of this, select Finish. The first pop-up you will see is the Ethernet IP configuration wizard. The only thing that needs to be configured here is a station with the correct IP address of the Compactlogix. Select Station and Add, and modify the PLC type to Compactlogix. Then, scroll down and enter the IP address of the PLC. Select OK, and now I can add in tags from my PLC project. An option to import tags from a database will open. Rockwell software allows projects to be saved as an L5K file or CSV file. I'll import my sample project from an L5K file. Once opened, all the tags in the project will populate. Only select the tags needed and select Import. Data communication between the PLC is now configured. The next step is to create a data logger within our project that will publish the tags collected from the Compactlogix to the AWS cloud. To add a data logger, simply right-click on the data logger resource and select Add a New Data Logger. To push data to the cloud, the Enable Archiving on Cloud option must be selected. For environments with an unstable internet connection, it is possible to save data packets to the router memory while an internet connection is unavailable. You can use this feature by selecting the Enable Offline Data option. The final step in configuring the data logger is to determine how and when to add data to the data logger. Data can be recorded whenever a tag value changes using the Records On Change option or using a Rising Edge trigger bit with the Record On command option. My PLC program will trigger the recording value every 6 seconds. The data logger will automatically set the trigger back to false. Therefore, I will check Record On command and enter the trigger in the recording variable. Each data logger contains columns for data. I'll use the tag water temp as the only column in this example and select the green check mark to save my changes. The next step will be to set the time period for data publishing. This can be found in the project properties. I'll leave everything at default. Every minute, a packet of data will be pushed to the cloud. Lastly, I will create a screen with a data logger template to see the data that is getting pushed to the cloud. These can be extremely useful for debugging. Open the toolbox and drag a data logger window on the new screen. Then, link the data logger to the window in the execution properties, and if you want, you can modify the columns you want to see. I'll only include the timestamp and the value of the water temp for this example. Now our data logging project is complete. Before we can load and run the project, we need to first transfer the security certificate files we first download from the connection wizard, and also set a few MQTT parameters for the router. A root CA certificate will be needed for the SSL connection. This can be downloaded from semantic.com. I'll provide this in the file package below. After we log in to COMBIVIS Connect, I'll create a folder called certificates. Copy the file ending in cert.pem and private.key, and then transfer them to the router using COMBIVIS Connect. Remember this file path for later, as we will need it in our configuration file. Finally, we will need to edit the MQTT configuration file. This file will be used by the router and defines all the MQTT parameters needed to push data to the AWS cloud. This can be found in the Resources folder of the COMBIVIS Studio HMI project. Remember, the correct configuration of this file is critical for the connection to the AWS cloud. It's important to review these settings carefully before you save the project. At this point, you can pause the video. Make sure you know the thing name, its endpoint, the topic name that we previously set as raw, and the paths that you defined for the security certificate files. After filling this out, select Save and close the file. The final step is to load the project to the C6 router and run it. To do this, right-click on the project title and select Upload Project to Device. Enter the IP address of the router and the desired path for the project and select Upload. After the upload is complete, select Start Device Project. Once the project fully boots up, the router will attempt to connect to the AWS cloud and begin to push data. First, look at the project dashboard and verify that the data is collecting. It looks like it is, so at this point, I'll open up my AWS console again and navigate to the DynamoDB service. You will refresh the page and you will see live data getting published to the database. If you do have errors, I would suggest going to the CloudWatch logs so you can see exactly what's going on. We can open up CloudWatch from here, and I'll look at the latest logs that we have available. This log shows that the Lambda function completed in just under 1 second successfully with no errors. From here, data can be abstracted and analyzed using other AWS services. For more information on KEB C6 Router and COMBIVIS Connect, see the links in the description below.